Welcome everyone to Celebration Family Worship Center. We are so glad you're here today, and we just love you guys, and we just wanted to say welcome. And I want to remind you of your verse last week, Philippians 4:4. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. And when you have Jesus in your heart, you can be happy all the time, no matter. And today we're going to talk about 10 lepers. And we're going to go into that in just a little bit. But I brought some friends, and they said if I'd run their sound, that they would sing 2 or 3 songs for me today. So that's what I'm going to do. So let me go call them. Hey, guys, puppets, wake up back there. Wake up. Hey, wake up. Are you ready? Come on up when you're ready. So I'll know. There you come. Oh, it's so good to see you today. Get a little higher so the children can see how pretty your clothes are. Oh, that is so pretty. Oh, my goodness. Jesus. Rejoice in the Lord always, and you can be happy in right, out right, upright, down right. No matter what's going on, you rejoice in the Lord always and be thankful. Hey guys, can you think you can do another song? You did so great. Let me call her and see. Are you there? Oh, come on back. I think she's going to come back. There she is. Give her a hand. Woo! You can do another one? I'm so glad. Turn to Luke, and that's in the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke. So we're going to go to chapter 17, and we're going to go to verses 11 through 17. Now, I'm not going to read all of them to you, but I want you to open your Bible and see where the story comes from. We're talking about Jesus and the 10 lepers. So now I want to read the first verse to you, which is 11. Can you go to 11? That's the little number. 17, Luke 17, verse 11. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. I'll read one more. And as he was going into the village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. And that's what we want to talk about today. Do you know what leprosy is? Leprosy is not a leopard. It's not an animal. It's back in the time when Jesus lived, it was a skin condition. And it would affect your skin and it would make sores all over them. And it was very contagious. In fact, the priest would look at them and cut the hair away and clean it and tell them to leave. They could not stay in town. They could not stay with their family. They had to go outside of town, outside their village, and live alone. They had to go alone. In fact, not only did they couldn't see their family and couldn't live with their family, and they couldn't see their friends in town, they had to go out and carry a bell, and every time someone came by, they had to shout, "Unclean, unclean," and ring their bell, or whatever they had. Unclean! So that people would not come near them. And it just so happened that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem, where there were 10 men that kind of huddled up together. And those 10 men had leprosy. And they had spots all over their fingers. In fact, it would make their fingers just like not work. It would make all sorts of their body parts not work, and they didn't have a cure for it. And they saw Jesus coming, and they said, "Master! Master! Come, Master! Have pity on us! Help us, Master! Have pity on us!" And Jesus stopped, and the disciples were with Jesus, and they jumped back because they did not want to be around anybody with leprosy. It was against the law for anybody to be around them, the Jewish law. But Jesus, he said, "Go to the church." They called it temple then. And they said, "Go to the priest," which is what we would call our pastors. "Go to them and show yourself." And they took off running, all 10 of them. And the priest looked at them and they were cured. Because that's what Jesus said. When you go to the priest, you're going to be cured. And those men were looking at themselves because they were in such pain and agony, and it doesn't tell how long they've been there, but they were hurting very bad. And they were running, and as they were running, they were seeing their skin heal up. And they ran to the priest, and guess what? 9 men went home or went somewhere, but one man out of 10 ran back to Jesus, and he fell before Jesus' feet, and he said, "Thank you, Master. Thank you, Master. Thank you." He was thankful in his heart. He did not come to Jesus and say, "Why didn't you come earlier and heal me? Look what I've missed." He didn't say, "I hurt so bad, didn't you know?" But these men, they prayed. And at the right time, Jesus came their way. And when Jesus healed them, one man came back. And he was a Samaritan. He wasn't even a Jew. And the Jewish people looked down on the Samaritans. They didn't like them. But he came back and fell face in front of Jesus and said, "Thankful." I want you guys to know, it sounded a little bit like coronavirus. You know what we've all been hearing about? Did you know that the priest would look at them every 7 days and cut the hair away from their arm and clean it and send them back out? And then they'd bring them back in another on the 7th day and look, and they would send them out for 7 more days. And after 14 days, they kept them out there, and they had to go around saying, "Unclean, unclean," so no one would come near them. But that's the way our heart is. You know, our heart is unclean. It's very unclean until we ask Jesus in our heart. He's the only way that can clean our heart up. Jesus was the only way he could clean the leper's skin. They had no medicine for it. Jesus healed those men, and 1 out of 10 was thankful. And he came back. I want you guys to take a look at your life. I want you to see what you have, your mom, your dad, your home, your grandparents, whatever toys or whatever you have. Don't be looking for the next best thing. Be thankful. Tell your mom and dad, thank you. Tell God, thank you. Tell Jesus, thank you. You know, he lived in heaven. He didn't have to come down here and die a horrible death on the cross. He could have stayed in heaven, but he loved us so much that he knew there was no way for us to get to heaven, so he came. So we need to be thankful to Jesus. That I've got another puppet song, and then I want to show you something else. But I want you to learn, as that one leper was thankful, I want you to be that one person on your end that's thankful today. And I want you to give thanks to Jesus for what he's done for you. It's easy to get sad. It's easy to let things bother you. Things bother me sometimes and I get aggravated. But just say, I'm sorry, Lord, and clean my heart back up. And he will. He will. Be thankful. I got another little puppet. I named him Nathaniel. And I was hoping he could come and do a song. I think he's taking a little bit of time right this second. Hello? Hello? Can you come up? Hey! Do you think you can do a song for me today? All right. Can I do your song? I don't want to do that song. Is that all right? In the name of Jesus, we can be saved. This man is thankful. Jesus told him, "Get up and leave, for your faith has made you whole." That's the last verse on there. Your faith in Jesus can make you whole. Jesus is the same way back in the Bible times as he is now. I just want to show you something. This is the way a lot of people are. You know, some people say, "Well, if I just had a boat, I would just be so happy." Let me see if I can make a boat. You know, I'm not real, you know, the most creative person. I may need to lay this down. But hey, this looks enough like a sailboat right here, doesn't it? Ooh, I'm going to sail. I've got a boat. It's going to make me happy. It's going to make me so happy. Oh, the wind stopped. Well, this is not fun anymore. The wind stopped. You know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to go buy me a house. That's what I'm going to do. Let's see. I will buy me a house. And I know I'll just put all kinds of fun games in it. I'll have Game Boy and drums and guitars and fishing rods. And I'll have all kinds of fun things in this house. Pac-Man. I know Walmart sells those Pac-Man games. But I love it. But, oh, you get so bored with it. I mean, you're staying home. Are you tired of staying home right now? We got tired of staying home here. Well, let's just say they're going to go on a jet plane to, where do you want to go? Arizona? Let's go to Arizona. Let's make us a plane right here. I'll have to use this right myself right here, but let's make a plane. Now, I'm tired of this place. Let's go to Miami. Woo! Woo! Well, let me fly to Myrtle Beach. Just got so tired. It just didn't give him as much joy. So one day, here's a steeple right here. He went inside a church and he said, "Look." He said, "I've got a house, I got a boat, I got a plane, I got all kinds of stuff in that house, I got all kinds of toys and stuff that keeps me playing, but I'm just not happy all the time on the inside." Well, the people in the church said, "Well, you just need not to depend on those things." Well, this man, he decided that, well, he's just going to throw them away. You don't have to do that to get right with God. God loves to bless you. But this man just wanted to focus on Jesus. And you know what? He was focusing on the cross. Because the cross is where the action happened. And after Jesus was nailed to that cross for our sins, they took him down, they put him in the grave, and on the third day he rose again. And he's alive today as he was when he was born. He's alive today and he can make you whole. If you want to be made whole, if you want to ask Jesus in your heart for the very first time, we can do it right now. If you just want to ask Jesus to come into your heart, just rededicate your heart. Say, "You know, I love Jesus, but I just haven't been living for him my whole life. And I just want to give my life back to him." Let's just say a prayer together. Dear Jesus, I love you. Forgive me of my sin. Come live in my heart. Help me live for you every day. And I thank you, Jesus, that you love me enough to come from heaven. I thank you enough that you love me enough to die on the cross. I thank you enough, Jesus, that you rose from the dead. I thank you that you did that for my sin so that I could go to heaven and have a clean heart. Thank you, Jesus, for helping me. Amen. If you've asked Jesus in your heart for the first time or rededicated it, they are throwing a party in heaven for you. God loves you so much. And if you need our help with anything, please let us know. If you need a Bible, we'll get you a Bible. If you just need to hook up and have someone pray with you, we'll pray with you. God loves you. He loves you so much, he sent his only son to die on that cross. Please, please Continue your walk with the Lord. Don't let it just be.